Besides reading from a geodatabase, FME can also write data to a geodatabase by either writing to an existing geodatabase or creating a new geodatabase and writing data to it. There are also parameters in FME that allow you to use either an existing geodatabase or an Esri XML workspace document as a template to create a geodatabase with a predefined structure at the same time as it writes data to some of the tables. This also means that for complex workspaces, you will be able to copy domain and subtype definitions, relationships and network information, and annotation symbols from one geodatabase to another. In this tutorial, we will explore one approach for reading any format of data and writing it to a geodatabase using an XML workspace document as a template. Our source data consists of an Esri shapefile, a KML file, and an AutoCAD drawing file. The shapefile consists of a polygon representing the land boundary of a city. The KML dataset represents city neighborhoods, which is also a set of polygon geometries. The AutoCAD dataset uses line features to represent the boundaries of land parcels. In this translation, we will start with a new canvas and add readers and writers separately. Let's start by adding an Esri shape reader. Select the Vancouver land boundary file as the data. Next, let's add a Google KML reader. Select the Vancouver neighborhoods.kml file. When adding the KML reader, we will be prompted with a feature types dialog window. For this example, we will only select neighborhoods from the list. Finally, we will add a Dwg Dxf reader. Select the parcel lines AutoCAD source file. To expose the extended entity data of the DWG file, it is important to set the group entities by selection to attribute schema in the DWG Dxf reader parameters. The source AutoCAD DWG file consists of line features that represent the boundaries of property parcels. We wish to write them as polygons in the geodatabase, and in order to do so, we need to transform the data during translation. We can use an Area Builder transformer to accomplish this. The Area Builder takes a set of line features and creates polygons where the lines form topologically closed shapes. Another required task is to create an ID number for each parcel polygon. The Counter transformer is one way to do this. Starting from zero, each feature passing through the transformer receives an incremented numeric value as an attribute. To match what I know the output schema to be, the attribute will be named parcel ID. To write a geodatabase, we now need to add a writer. In the parameters dialog, we will choose to overwrite an existing version of this database, instead of adding data to it. Also, rather than creating the geodatabase from scratch, we will set a parameter to tell FME to use an ArcGIS XML workspace document as a template. Such a document can be created in ArcGIS as an export from an existing geodatabase. We now need to tell FME which tables from the template we intend to write data to at this point. We do this by setting the Add Feature Types parameter to Import From Dataset. When you click OK, FME will search the template for a list of tables. When prompted, we will select the three tables that we are writing to: Neighborhoods, Parcels, and Vancouver Land Boundary. Click OK. Once added, connect the output of the respective readers to the corresponding geodatabase writers. We should also check for attributes that don't match, So go ahead and expand the Neighborhoods Reader and Writer feature types. We can see that there are attributes that we need to fix. Let's do this by once again connecting the corresponding ports. Our final task will be to set the output coordinate system to be UTM-83-10. Go ahead and run the workspace, and then set the destination folder. Let's view the output with ArcMap. Although only 3 feature classes are defined, more feature classes than that will be created. The 3 feature classes in the workspace are the ones that we want to add data to as they are being created.